Walking down the street, my mandolin-shaped ass swaying and swinging to their backward eyes. How strange that I only completely knew this power when it was gone or transferred to my daughter, all male eyes on her nubile 20-ish body. Promising babies, all male eyes. I missed this power. It seemed that the things that had come to replace it, marriage, maternity, the wisdom of the mature woman, ugh, I hate that phrase, weren't worth the candle. Ah, the candle. Standing up, burning for me, full of sound and fury, signifying everything. I know I should fade away like a good old girl and spare my daughter the embarrassments of my passions, but I can't any more than I can conveniently die. Life is passion. But now that I know what passion costs, it's hard to be carefree anymore. But was I ever carefree? Was anyone? Wasn't love always an exploding cigar? Didn't Gypsy Rose Lee say, God is love, but get it in writing? And didn't Fanny Bryce say, love is like a card trick? Once you know how it works, it's no fun anymore. Those old broads knew a thing or two. And did they give up ever? Never. I'm not going to tell you yet how old I am or how many times I've been married. I have decided never to get any older than 50. My husband and I read the obituaries together more often than we have sex. I'm only going to say that when all the troubles of my family of origin engulfed me and I realized that my marriage could not save me, I reached a point where I was just unhinged enough to put the following ad on ziplist.com, a sex site on the internet. Happily married woman with extra erotic energy seeks happily married man to share same. Come celebrate Eros one afternoon a week. Discretion guaranteed by playful, pretty, imaginative, witty woman. Send email and recent picture, New York area. Talk about a woman on the verge of a nervous breakdown. It was an autumn in New York, season of mellow mists, Jewish holidays, and $5,000 plate benefits for chic diseases. A time of new beginnings, Yom Kippur, starting over, Rosh Hashanah, and laying in acorns against a barren winter, Sukkot. When I placed the ad, I had thought of myself as a sophisticated, coolly interviewing lovers. But now I was suddenly overcome with panic. I began fantasizing about what sort of creeps, losers, retreads, extortionists, and homicidal maniacs such an ad would attract. And then I got so busy with calls from my ailing parents and pregnant daughter that I forgot all about it.